Okay, students, last class we have solved two problems wherein the circuit was given to us and we did analyze the circuit and we wrote the state diagram, that is sequence we analyzed. Okay, we analyzed the output of the circuit, that means the circuit given was a counter, so we could analyze the counter circuit and we could tell what are the sequences that are going to generate from the circuit. So, in module 4, the first type of problems we have discussed is what? The first type of problems we have discussed is sequence will be given to us. For that sequence, we will design the circuit. That is one type. The second type is circuit will be given to us and we could analyze the circuit and write the sequence. Okay? Now, the third type of problems we have, wherein the state diagram will be given. State diagram will be given to us and we should analyze the state diagram and design a circuit for that state diagram. And state diagram, sequence, both are same. But here in this type of problems, whatever we are going to discuss now, we will have one external input variable also. See, in the counter, the state diagram will be what? 000, 001. Like that, 010. So like that, state diagram will be given. So this is the sequence, 012. So you know from the sequence how to design the circuit. Now in this type problems, what we are going to discuss from now on, we will have one external input variable X and one output variable Y. So we have discussed Mealy and Moore model, correct? We have discussed Mealy and Moore model, wherein we know what is the difference between Mealy model and Moore model. Now, the third type of problem what we are going to discuss is when a state diagram is given, how we can design a circuit for the given state diagram. As I said, in the state diagram, we just don't have the states. We also have an external input variable X and an output variable Y. Okay, input variable and then you know what is the exact definition of input variable. All variables that originate outside the sequential machine are called as input variables. So whenever I tell input variable, it refers to the variable that is originated outside the sequential circuit. So in the state diagram, what they are going to get, we will have that input variable along with the flip-flop, along with the state variables, we will also have input variables and the output variables. And state diagram, we have different types of writing, different notations of writing the state diagram. And when a state diagram is given to you, you should be able to analyze that and write the excitation table for the counter. Only then, from the excitation table, we could derive the equations for state variables. From that, we can write the circuit. So, let me first write some notations of state diagram. How exactly state diagrams will be written? Different ways of writing the state diagram. So now, let me take an example of JK flip flop. Okay? Let me take an example of JK flip flop. All of us know what is the function table of JK flip flop. Now, what are the inputs we have? We will have JK, output Q, Q plus, that is next state. So now, at any point in your JK flip-flop, which are the test states we have? Let me write JK, Q plus. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. JK flip-flop, one bit it can store. So if it is 0, 0, it stores the previous bit. If it is 0, 1, it stores 0. If it is 1, 0, it stores 1. If it is 1, 1, 1, it stores Q bar, the complement of the previous state. Am I correct? So now, how many states we have? How many states? What is the meaning of state? How many different combinations of inputs we are storing? JK flip-flop is 1-bit storage element. So how many possible combinations of input? We can store either 0 or 1, correct? Flip-flop can store either 0 or 1. So Q means what? It can be, it is same as previous state. Previous state can be either 0 or 1. Q bar means what? Complement of previous state. Again, previous state is either 0 or 1. So how many states we have for the JK flip-flop? Only two. 0 or 1. This can be 0 or 1. This can also be 0 or 1. So we have two states for JK flip-flop. Let me call this state as AB. Okay, so before you write the state diagram, you must be very clear with the number of states. How many states? You should be knowing what is the meaning of state. Here for a flip-flop, state means the flip-flop content. We know all the flip-flops, all the four types of flip-flops can store either 0 or 1. So at any clock pulse, the content of the flip flop, the state of the flip flop can be either 0 or 1. So we will have two states, one is A and the other one is B. So let me assume that state A is 0, state B is 1. You can also take B as 0, A as 1. And just calling the state 0 as A, state B, state 1 as B. Two states, 0 or 1. Okay? So now, this is one way of writing these states. Okay? So we have two states AB. We have two states AB. Now what we are doing? We are writing the state diagram for JK flip-flop. State diagram for JK flip-flop. Now, let me start from the here. Let me start from state A. What is state here? 0. State A is nothing but state 0. If the flip-flop is in state 0, if the flip-flop is in state 0, what happens if I apply the input as 0, 0? Assume the previous state. This is nothing but the state. Now the flip-flop is in state 0. Now the flip-flop is in state 0. These are the inputs JK. Okay. What is the content of the flip-flop? 0. I give J as 0, K as 0. What is the flip-flop content? When you give J 0, K 0, what is the flip-flop content? Same as previous state. What is the present state? 0. So next state is what? Same. If I give J 0, K 0, what is the next state? Next state is same as present state. What is present state? 0. So when you give J 0, K 0, now also the flip-flop content is what? 0 only. Now also the flip-flop content is 0 only. So which is 0 state here? This one. So when you give J0, K0, when you give J0, K0, flip-flop will remain in same state. Correct. Flip-flop will remain in same state. That is why we write like this. So whatever that is written here, this will be the input. See this, what is the meaning of this? When input is 0, 0, the flip circuit will remain in the same state. Similarly, coming here. Okay? So now assume that flip-flop is in state 1. If you give J0, K0, what is the content of the flip-flop? J0, K0, flip-flop will remain in the same state. So if the flip-flop, JK flip-flop is in state 1, if you apply JK00, then the flip-flop will remain in same state. So again, it remains in the same state. 0, 0. So if the flip-flop is storing 1, you apply J0, K0, then also the content of the flip-flop will be 1 only. If the flip-flop is in state 0, if you apply J0, K0, it remains in same state. It remains in same state. Now, coming here, state is 0. If I apply J0, K0, it remains in same state. If I apply J0, K1, if I apply J0, K1, assume the previous state is 0. Okay, now the flip-flop is in state 0. This is state. A means state 0. B means state 1. Flip-flop is in state 0. If you apply J0, K0, it remains in same state. If you apply 0, 1, what is the output? Output is again state 0. Which is state 0? This is state 0. So, comma 0, 1. What does it mean? If the flip-flop is in state 0, apply input 0, 0, then also it remains in same state. Apply 0, 1, then also it remains in same state. Apply 1, 0, flip-flop is in state 0. You apply 1, 0, what is the next state? 1. So look at here. If the flip-flop is in state 0, if the input is 1, 0, it moves to the next state. What is the next state? 1. If you apply 1, 1, if the flip-flop is in state 0, if you apply 1, 1, complement of previous state. What is the previous state? 0. Next state is what? Complement of that. Complement of 0 is what? 1. So, comma 1, 1. That means, if the flip-flop is in state 0, if you apply 0, 0, it remains in same state. If you apply 0, 1, then also the state is 0. If you apply 1, 0, it moves to the next state. That is 1. If you apply 1, 1, it moves to the next state, 1. So, when you write the state diagram, it clearly gives us a picture. What is the present state? Then, if this is the present state, when I apply this input, what will be the next state? If it remains in the same state, this is how we write. Okay? So, for many combinations of input, it remains in the same state. We need not write one more arc. You can just write comma, input. 1 1, you need not write one more time. You can just put a comma and write 1 1. That means for these two combinations, if the flip flop is in state 0, it takes a transition to the next state. Next, if the flip flop state is 1, if it is in present state is 1. If it is 0 0, it remains in the same state. If it is 0 1, next state is what? 0. So if it is 0 1, next it takes a transition to the next state 0. 1 0, flip flop is in state 1. 1 0, what is the output? 1. Which is that 1 state? It is itself. So it remains in the same state. 1 1, complement of previous state. What is the previous state? 1. Complement means 0. So it should go to 0. Okay, so this is the state diagram of JK flip flop. This is the state diagram of JK flip flop. And we know that here the output is just depending on the inputs. We don't have any X input here. So this can be called as a Moore model. Moore model. The output depends on X also. X as well as the state variables, it is called as Wheeler machine. If the output depends only on the state variables, it is called as Moore machine. So this is an example for Moore machine, JK flip flop. This is one way of writing. The other way of writing is, instead of writing 0 here, output inside the circle, you can also write like this. That means state A is nothing but 0, state B is nothing but 1. So like this, we have different ways of writing the state diagram. Okay, you can refer your textbook, John M. Yarbrough textbook, wherein he has given so many notations of writing the state diagram. As we solve problems, we'll discuss different, we'll see how state diagrams will be written, different ways of writing the state diagram. But this is one method, one way. I'll write one more state diagram, wherein we will have X also. So now, assume again two states, I'll assume state A and state B. Okay. First I'll write the state diagram, then I'll explain what it is. Okay, some state diagram I'm writing it just to explain it. This is an example state diagram what I will be writing. Okay. Okay. See, if the state diagram is given like this, how to analyze? Look at how many states we have. We have two states. We have two states, A and B. Two states. And this, whatever that is written, when there is a transition, see, if you find like this, this will be the input, this will be the output. First one will be the input, next will be the output. So X is input here, Y is output. X is input, Y is output. Okay. Now state is two states, we have AB. Now, if the sequential circuit is in state A, look at this. What is X? X means if the variable is written X, that means it is taking 1. If it is written X bar, then that means the variable is taking 0. Now, if input is 1, if X is 1, what is output? If X is 1, what is output? Output is also written Y, that means Y is 1. If it is Y bar, it is 0. Output is also 1. State, present state is A. If the present state is A, if input is 1, output will be 1. Where arrow mark? Arrow mark is in the same state. That means it remains in the same state. Next state is also what? Next state is also A only. Next state is also A. Next, if the present state is A, look at this. If input is 0, output is what? 1. And if the present state is A, arrow mark I'm trying to analyze. If present state, this is going from A to B, right? So if present state is A to B it is going. When X is 0, if the present state is A, it is going to where? B. When output is what? When output is 1. Similarly, we have completed, now state A we have completed. When state A, one possibility is X is 1, one possibility is X is 0. Come to state B. State B. Look at this. If x is 0, if x is 0, what is y? Y is 1. Next state is what? If x is 0, next state is B only. Next state is B. What is the output? 1. This arrow mark you see, this arrow mark. If the present state is B, if x is 1, what is output? 0. Next state is what? A. So arrow mark is very important. So here in the arrow mark, whatever that is written first, that is input. The next will be output. So like this, we have different ways of writing the state diagram. Okay? So this is just the basics. Only three ways I explained. So let us take down the first problem. We'll see how state diagrams are going to be analyzed. Okay? So let me take the first problem. Okay, this is a question from June-July 2014 paper. June-July 2014 question paper. Realize the system represented by the following state diagram. Realize the system represented by the following state diagram using D flip-flop, JK flip-flop. Okay. So I just copy the question. State diagram, I just copy. So in this arrow mark is going to be very, very important. Arrow marks are very important because that indicates transition to next, which state? Transition to the next state, correct? Okay, so this is the state diagram we just gave it. The question is to realize the system represented by the following state diagram. Realize the system represented by the following state diagram using D flip-flop, first one, and then using JK flip-flop, that is second one. Okay. So now, first thing what we have to do is, we have to analyze how many states we have got. How many states? So number of states. Number of states. How many states we have? 1, S1, S2, S3. S1, S2, S3. 3 states we have, right? Sometimes what is that state will also be given in the problem. But now they have not given us what is the state. State means what is the information that is, what is the pattern or what is the sequence of state S1, S2, S3 is not given. So if you have problems like this, you can assume the states S1, S2, S3. So let S1, S2, S3. So if it is only 2 states, I can take S1 as 0, S2 as 1. But here I have 3 states. So I have to take one more bit, right? So S1, let me assume S1 is 0, 1, 0, 0. S2 is 0, 1. S3 is 1, 0. You can assume any states. You can take S1 as 0, 1. S2 as 1, 0. S3 as 1, 1. You can take S1 as 1, 0, S, any ways you want. But generally when the states are given, we take it in order 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. It is up to you how you are going to assume the values for, assume the states S1, S2, S3. This is how I have taken S1 as 0, 0, S2 as 0, 1, S3 as 1, 0. So 3 states. So now it is time for us to write the excitation table for this by analyzing the state diagram. So the next step is very important. And how many flip-flops are required? How many flip-flops? Next thing, what you have to decide is number of flip-flops. How many flip-flops are required? We have 3 states. How many bits? 2 bits. 2 bits. So how many flip-flops? 2 flip-flops. Number of flip-flops? 2. So type of flip-flop that they have given the problem itself. First problem is to realize the system using D flip-flop. Second one is to JK flip-flop. I will be doing it using D. The same thing you can follow for design state diagram using JK. So type of flip-flop is D. Type of flip-flop is D. So we want 2 D flip-flops to get 3 states. Okay, so now let us write the excitation table. You know how will be the excitation table for this? So excitation table, what are the columns we have? Present state. Okay, we will also have here in this problem, as you can see the state diagram, we know that we have an input variable x. If these are not given, that means it is just the next state. So we will not be having any external input variable. But here x is also given, so that means we have an input variable. Along with the present state, we have input variable, that is x. Present state is what? So let me call this as A, let me call this as B. Output of first flip-flop, I call it as A. Output of second flip-flop, I call it as B. Output of first flip-flop, DA, DB. Two flip-flops we have, no? Output of first flip-flop, I call it as A. Output of second flip-flop, I call it as B. Okay? So present state is A, B, input is what? X. You can even write input first and then the present state. Okay? It is not that we have to take the first column as present state. You can even change. You can write the input first and then the present state. There will be X, A, B. You have to be very careful when you write the K map then. But the equations what you get will be same for both. So present state, input. Next is what? Next state, that is A plus, B plus, next, fifth flop inputs, what, how many fifth-flops we have? Two. So let me call the fifth-flop inputs as DA, DB, fifth-flop inputs, DA, DB, fifth-flop outputs, AB, right? And we also have one more variable, that is output variable. What is that? How they have denoted it as? They have called it as Z. So these are the columns we will have in the excitation table of the given state diagram. The given state diagram, right? Okay. Are you able to see the table? Whatever I have written.
No. Okay. Okay, so these are the columns we have in the excitation table. So what is that? Present state. Present state A, B, and we have an input variable, that is X. Okay.
And next state, flip-flop inputs and then output variable, right? Okay. So which are the inputs we have? A, B, X. We have the inputs as A, B, X. So three input variables we have, present state A, B, X. So how many different possible combinations we will have? Three input variables. So which are the possible combinations? Possible combinations will be how many? 8, 0 to 7. So write all the 8 possible combinations here. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, correct? 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1, including x, including input, it is three variable. As I said, you can even write first x, then AB, then this will be x, this will be AB, right? So 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1, so this will be 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, right? Okay. Now the inputs, present state and the input, I've written all the possible combinations. Now let us analyze the state diagram and fill the excitation table. Now A, B, 0, 0. 0, 0 corresponds to which state? S1. 0, 0 means S1. The first row, if the state is S1, so 0, 0 means S1. 0, 1 means S2. 1, 0, it is S3. 1, 1, there is no state, so we'll be writing, don't care, okay? So, 0, 0, if the present state is 0, 0, that means, if the present state is S1, now, you have to analyze the state S1. So, you have to concentrate only on state S1, because you are taking the state as S1. So now the state is S1. Now the circuit is in state S1. Okay. So just check how many arrows are going out. So this is one. This is going out. And this is going out. Correct? This is going out. Fine. Now. So now if the input is in state S1, if X is 0, if X is 0, so X is written here, X is written here. So we have two arrows going out from S1. That means the present state is S1. There are two transitions. Just check in which the X is 0. X is 0 means X bar should be there. What do we have here? We have X. No. Come here. What is the value that is written for this transition? X bar. That means if this present state is S1, if the input is X0, X bar means what? If the input is 0. That is what is first row, right? If the state is S1, 0, 0. If the input is 0. If the input is 0, what is next state? Look at the arrow mark where it is going. It is coming back again to same state S1. So if the input is S1, 0, 0. Present state is 0, 0. If the input is 0, what is next state? S1. What is S1? 0, 0. What is S1? 0, 0. And what is the value of Y? For this, what is Y? Z bar. Z bar means what? 0. Z is output variable. Y is nothing but Z here. So what is Z? Z is also 0. So this is how, looking at the state diagram, you write the excitation table. Now, what is the present state? Same S1. So now, again same S1. If the state is S1, if input is 1, if input is 1, so see, if the input is 1, that means X. If the input is 1, what is the next state? So if the input is 1, there is a transition from S1 to S2. S1 to S2. What is S2? S2 is 0, 1. So there is a transition to S2, 0, 1. What is output? Z bar. Z bar means 0. Transition to the next state 0, 1. Output is 0. Okay. Now, state is S2. Now, present state is what? S2. If the input is 0, if the input is 0, state S2. Which are the arrows that are going out? This is 1 and this is 1. Going out. This arrow is coming in. So these two are going out. So now check where input is 0. See here input is 1. So this is the transition where input is 0. If input is 0, next state is what? Next state is S1. And what is output? 0. Next state is S1. S1 is what? 0, 0. And what is output? 0. Output is 0. Now state S2, input is 1. State S2, input is 1. What is the next state? S3. What is output? 0. What is S3? 1, 0. What is output? 0. Okay, this is how you write. Now, what is the next state? S3. So, S3. Two arrows are going out. This is 1 and this is 1. Now, so the present state is S3. If input is 0, if input is 0, so this is the arrow. If input is 0, next state is what? S3 only. Output is what? Z bar, 0. Next state is S3. That is 1, 0. Output is 0. Right? Next. If the present state is S3, if X is 1, what is the next state? Next state is S1. Output is 1. Next state is S1. S1 is what? 0, 0. Output is what? 1. Output is 1. For the next two conditions, we just write don't care, because that is not in the sequence. I cannot write it as 0 because we don't know whether where will be the transition. So we will be just writing it as X. So this is how the state diagram will be analyzed, and we will write the excitation table for the given state diagram. Now you know how to write the flip-flop inputs. How do we write the flip-flop inputs? DA. Look at A plus and write DA. Look at B plus and write DB. So what is DA? If the previous state is 0, if the next state is 0, to get next state as 0, what should be DA? Look at the excitation table of DA and write this. You know this. So this will be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. This is x, x. This will be 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, x, x. To write this, you have to refer the excitation table of JF, D flip flop. Excitation table of D flip flop. Q, Q plus D. 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Excitation table of D flip flop, you have to refer and you have to fill this. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. Sorry, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. This is X. So this is what the excitation table for the given state diagram. So when you write the excitation table, next step, you know how to design a circuit. Derive the equations for DA and DB. So derive the equations for DA, DB in terms of what? Input. So how many input variables we have? We have three input variables, A, B, X. So I need three variable K-map. So inputs are A, B, X. So 0, if you write x first, a, b next, you are going to take here as x, a, b, okay? So 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So dA, I am deriving an equation for dA, right, in terms of a, b, x. So what are the mean terms we have? We have 3, 4. Mean terms are 3, 4. 3, 4, right? 3, 4, 6, 7, it is don't care. For the remaining cells, we have 0. Now group the cells. Can we group 3 and 7? Yes. So if I group 3 and 7, we get ABX. And if I group 4 and 6, I get A. What is that? A, X bar, right? Yeah. Okay. So DA is equal to AX bar plus BX. Similarly, derive an equation for DB. Again, three variable came up. A, B, X, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The mean terms are 1, only 1, right? 1. For 6 and 7 it is, I don't care. Okay, so for other cells it is 0. So group the cells, how do we group the cells? One alone, right? Because it is not adjacent to any other cells. So what is the equation we get? A bar, V bar, X. A bar, V bar, X. So DB is equal to A bar, V bar, X. Similarly, it is not only for DA, DB, we also have to derive an equation for what? Z. Can you see these three variable camera I have written? You can see. Similarly, we have to derive an equations for, we have, yeah, you can see, right? Yes. Similarly, derive an equation for Z. So again, three variable camera. Okay. So, three variable came up to derive an equation for Z. Okay, A, B, X, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? So, mean terms for Z, it is only 5. Other cells, they are taking 0 other than 6 and 7. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So how do we group it? Can we group 5 and 7? So if I group 5 and 7, what is the equation? I get A, X. So what is that? Z is equal to A, X. So we have derived the equations for the flip-flop inputs as well as for Z. So what is next? Next is to write the circuit. So write the circuit for the given, for the derived equations. So how do we write the circuit? How many flip-flops we have? We have two flip-flops. DA, DB. Two flip-flops. DA, Q, Q bar. Okay. DB. So DB, Q, Q bar. Let us take both positive edge trigger J, B flip-flop. Give clock pulse directly to B flip-flop. Synchronous circuit. Okay. Next, what is DA? DA is what? And what is the output of first flip-flop? It is A. What is the output of second flip-flop? We are calling it as B, right? What is DA? A X bar. Okay. A is what? This. So this is A. Okay. A. X bar. So X bar is one external input we can take. So I'll just write the equations here, because Z is equal to AX, DA is equal to AX bar plus VX, DB is equal to A bar B bar X. So DA is what? AX bar. So X is the variable that is outside the sequential circuit. But I want X bar, right? So I take it as X bar. So I have A, X bar, plus I give these two an AND gate. So what I'm getting here, A, X bar I'm getting, plus B, X. So B. Okay, where is B? This is B. B, the other input is X. Okay, so what is the output I'm getting here? Bx. Ax bar I have, Bx I have, plus. So use an OR gate, give that to D. So what is the output of OR gate? Ax bar plus Bx. This is how you write the circuit in the exam. Okay? Then this is DA is equal to Ax bar plus Bx. What is DB? A bar, B bar X. So A bar is here only. This is A, this is A, this will be A bar. A bar, B bar. A bar, B bar, X. So where is X? X is here, right? So take the same X. So give these to an AND gate. The output of AND gate is now the input for DB. A bar, B bar, X. Right? Okay. Now what is Z? Z is AX. So this is A. X. So this is X. So yeah, yes. So this is A, this is X and B. So what is that? This is Z. So this is the circuit for the given state diagram. Z is AX, DA is AX bar plus BX, DB is A bar, B bar, X. Okay, so this is how when a state diagram is given to us, we can analyze the state diagram and write the circuit for the same. Okay? Okay, we shall take one more problem. The state diagram is given like that. Okay, one more problem. This is also taken from previous equation paper.
So that is the state diagram given. And for this, we have to analyze the state diagram and write the circuit using JK flip-flop. We have to write the circuit using JK flip-flop. So let us do that. Okay. So in this, if you just look at the state diagram, the last state diagram, we had assumed what is S1 and S2. But here, look at the state diagram. They have only given what is the states. So how many states we have? S1, S2, S3, S4. So we have four states. 00, 01, 10, 11. Each state, what is the state? That also they have given. That is how the state diagram is different from the last one. Last diagram, we had assumed what are the states. S1 as 00, S2 as 01, S3 as 10. But here, no assumption, they have only given. So, how many states we have? We have four states. 00, 01, 00, 01, 10, 11. So, how many flip-flops? So, this is A and this is B. Two bits. So, number of flip-flops are two. Two are enough. Flip-flop type, in the question only they have given use JK flip-flop. So let us use JK flip-flop to design. Okay.
So directly we can start writing the excitation table for this. So what are the columns we will have in excitation table? Present state. Let me assume the outputs as A, B, flip flop output. So it is present state A. Input variable. They have not even denoted the input variable. So let us denote the input variable as X. Then next state we have, that is A plus, B plus. Then after next state we have flip flop inputs. So JK flip flop, so it is JA, KA, the inputs of first flip flop. JB, KB, the inputs of second flip flop. And output variable, what is our output? Let us call the output variable as Y. Okay.
Okay, hope you can see the table, complete table, what I have written. Okay, yeah. So now,
okay, A, B, X, we have three input variables. So how many different combinations? 8, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay, so now, if the present state is 0, 0, such where it is present state 0, 0, this is the state. If present state is 0, 0, if input is 0, where is input? You have to check the arrows that are going out. So this is the arrow that is going out, and this is coming in, and this is going out. And now, in these two, check where X is 0. Whatever the value that is written first, that is X. Either you take it, they can give this as X bar, or they have written it as X. So this is input output like that. In the last state diagram, it was given x bar slash y bar, x slash y like that. So in first input, then the output. So what is the condition? Present state is 0, 0. Yeah, machine is in state 0, 0. If input is 0, where is 0, 0? This is what? This is when input is 1. This is when input is 0. So when input is 0, yeah, we got it. Next state is what? Next state is also same. Next state is what? Transition to the same state. So what is next state? 0, 0. What is output? 0. So output is 0. Next, if the present state is 0, 0. So this is done. If the present state is 0, 0, if x is 1, transition to 1, 0. If x is 1, transition to 1, 0, output is 1. Transition to 1, 0, output is 1. Fine. Next, over. Next state is 0, 1. If 0, 1 is the present state, if input is 0, if present state is 0, 1, check the two arrows that are going out. This is 1 and this is 1. If present state is 0, 1, if input is 0, yeah, here we have 0. If input is 0, output is 0, transition to 1, 1. If input is 0, transition to 1, 1, output is 0. Correct? Output is 0. Next. Present state is 0, 1. If input is 1, present state is 0, 1. Next state is 0, 0, output is 0. Next state is 0, 0, output is 0. Next, if present state is 1, 0, two arrows that are going out, these two. If input is 0, here we have 0. If input is 0, transition to the same state, output is 1. Transition to the same state, output is 1. Next, if the state is 1, 0, if input is 1, transition to 0, 1, output is 0. Transition to 0, 1, output is 0. If the state is 1, 1, these two are going out. If input is 0, transition to 0, 0, output is 1. Transition to 0, 0, output is 1. Next, if the state is 1, 1, 1, 1, yeah, if the input is 1, transition to 1, 0, output is 0. Okay, so this is the table we have. This is the excitation table for the given car, for the given state diagram, right? Yes. Okay, so now how do you write JAK, JB, KB? By looking at the excitation table of JK flip flop. You can write the excitation table one side and you can write. So now 0, 0. To write JAK, you have to look AA plus. 0, 0, 0x. 0, 1, 1x. 0, 1, 1x. Okay, 0, 0, 0x. 1, 1, x, 0. 1, 0, x, 1. 1, 0, x, 1. 1, 1, x, 0. JBKB. 0, 0, 0x. You have to look BP plus. 0, 0, 0x. 1, 1, x, 0. Right? 1, 0, x, 1. Then, sorry. 0, 0, 0x. Next, 0, 1, 1x. 1, 0, x, 1. 1, 0, x, 1. So, this is the excitation table and you have to derive the equations for JA, KA, JB, KB and Y. I hope you are very clear with the equation, derive the equations. So I don't derive the equations here, as you all know how to derive the equations using three variable KMAP. A, B, X are going to be the inputs. I'll just write the equations. You can do it and you can verify. J is B X bar plus B bar X. And K A is X B bar plus B X bar, that is B X or X you're going to get. J B is A X. KB is A plus X and Y is A bar, B bar, X plus A, X bar. And from this only you can tell whether it is a Wheeler machine or Moore machine. What is this? Output is function of the state variables A, comma B as well as X. So this is a Wheeler machine, right? This is a Wheeler machine. From this only you can tell it is depending on input variables. Obviously it is a Wheeler machine, right? So yeah, these are the equations. And from the equations, you can even write the circuit diagram. You have to write the circuit diagram. Okay, you can write the circuit diagram for the equations what you have got. Please verify the equation, solve using KMAP. Okay, and the last problem also, I have done it using only D flip-flop. You have to do it, the same problem, do it using JK. Last problem, the first problem what we have worked out. In the paper, they have asked for using JK flip-flop also. Same, in the same excitation table, you just add one more column. JAKA, JBKB. Derive the equations for JAKA, JBKB and write one more circuit. Okay? So this is how we analyze. This is another type of problem where we get the circuit, sorry, state diagram. That state diagram you have to analyze and for that you have to write the circuit. Okay? Thank you.